Hello there. It's Christmas soon, apparently, in case you couldn't tell from the very tasteful decoration in today's video. So instead of playing some bad Christmas covers, I thought it's a better idea to end this year by sitting down with all of you guys and girls to have a little fireside chat. So without further ado, in this video, I'd like to answer some of your most frequently asked questions. So before we get to the really interesting YouTube comments, I'd like to answer one of the most frequently asked questions on Patreon right now that you guys and girls sent me over there. And this one is unsurprisingly about equipment around Christmas time. I wonder if there's a coincidence. What is the best guitar for shredding? So for fast alternate picking, sweeping, just playing fast in general. When I started out really working on those techniques and practicing, taking it really seriously a couple of years ago, I mainly went for one of the biggest stereotypes, I guess, super thin necks and very low action when it comes to the height of the strings. But this year I decided to go for something a bit different with this guitar. And no, this won't be a guitar commercial or a sales video. I just really recommend trying out this approach in case you haven't already. So this Ibanez AC Prestige model actually has a bit of a thicker neck, as you can see, and that has really helped me with getting rid of that extra tension I had in my left hand, especially when I was playing live. And this guitar and overall neck profile was a pretty big game changer for me this year, especially when it comes to legato and all of those techniques. As you can see, the action also isn't set to extremely super low. It's actually the factory setting. I really liked it that way. So it would be really great and helpful for the community if you could share your personal experience and opinion in the comments. Do you like and prefer the shred stereotype, the super thin neck and the low action? Or did you also experiment with other things this year, and what's your personal favorite guitar? I'd love to hear about that. So now that I have probably successfully started the fight over the best guitar brand and model in the comment section, let's move to your YouTube comments. Ja Beck is asking, I hope that I got the name correctly, you mentioned speed zones, very slow, medium and fast. If you practice, let's say, alternate picking for 1 hour a day, how much time do you spend in each zone? And is it a fixed number of minutes or just a byproduct of using the speed ladder method in your practice sessions? Thanks a lot for this very detailed and interesting question. That's a really good one. The main reason why I talk so much about all those different tempo zones in your playing is because I made the big mistake of ignoring the mid-tempo range for quite a long time. So I would slowly study exercises to get a feeling for them, and then, as we probably all like to do, I was pushing the tempo immediately to see how fast I can execute them. This also especially goes for warming up for live performances, even into the beginning of 2019, last year when concerts were still allowed. I thought that I would warm up both my hands really effectively by playing as fast as possible. But since the very fast motion is kind of different from the mid-tempo motion and very different from the slow motion, I was only warming up one aspect of my playing style. So that was kind of my key moment and experience when it comes to differentiating between those different time zones. The motion changes during the BPM ladder, and that's why it's so important for me to include all those different time zones in my personal routine. So I do have a structured approach when it comes to that. Right now I start my day with 25 minutes of alternate picking exercises, but I don't put an exact timer like 30 seconds or 44 seconds or 23 seconds for every single BPM step. I start by playing 16th notes at around 70 or 80 beats per minute, and then I just move my way up until I reach 200, 210 or 220 beats per minute. So when you repeat that cycle often enough, you get a feeling for how long you should spend in each time zone, so none of them are neglected. And right now I still really love working with this exercise, and I think you should really check it out. That's the one I'm talking about. Up next is Michael Craig with his comment, and he says, BERNTH. Thanks a lot for commenting that. Please let me know in the comments if I should change the channel's name to that. But on a more serious note, I know that my name is pretty hard to pronounce. I had a lot of fun with that on my first tour through the United States. So it actually would be BERNTH, but you can also say BERNTH if you prefer that. The next one is really interesting. That one is from Lawrence Garza, and he says, when you hold your pick, do you hold it with the pad of your index finger and thumb, or do you hold it in between the nail and pad of the index finger? This is a really good and very important question, so thanks a lot for asking it. Maybe I will make a video about it in detail. But just to discuss it real quick, I actually changed that recently. I used to hold my pick like that, And as I mentioned in a different video, one of the biggest problems that came with that is that my other right-hand fingers were scraping against the strings, and that was generating a lot of unwanted noise while I was playing. And now that I hold the pick like that once again, it kind of feels unnatural for me. So the change I recently made was holding my pick like that. And I know this looks like a very subtle and small change, but it makes all the difference, because that right here feels very, very natural to me. If I leave the pick out of the equation, just holding my hand like that and putting my thumb right here feels very natural, like you're supposed to do that. Well, when you do that, it kind of feels a bit strange. If you would like to try that out right now, you can just do that and compare those two motions and see what feels better for you. And you can just place your pick right here after that and just close your hand and try out that grip. So when I'm playing like that, my fingers are not scraping against the strings anymore. That was actually the main reason why I was using a fret wrap in tons of older videos. I thought it's because I still have a lot of work to do with my left hand when it comes to unwanted noise, but it was actually my right hand that was scraping against the strings a bit. Now that I hold the pick like that, my fingers are not touching the strings anymore, and that really, really cleaned up my playing. So that's what I would recommend for you to try out. The next one is from Aldrin Malikay, and he says, your face looks like the painting of Mona Lisa. I haven't seen that painting for a while. Let's take a quick look and see if that's true. Okay, that's not how I remember it, so maybe you're onto something. The next comment is from ADR86 Mods, and he says, I watched your video and noticed my picking hand, so the right hand, that I keep my middle ring and pinky slightly bent. I then tried keeping a fist and noticed immediately that my playing was much more accurate and sounded cleaner. So this is another very commonly asked question about picking technique that I get. I also actually started out with an open hand approach a couple of years ago, but there were some problems that I had with that. On one hand, I was kind of touching pretty much everything around here. I was turning off the knobs when I was playing live because the movement was getting bigger and I was scratching up all of my guitars right here. So at one point I just started closing my fist like that because I saw that at the conservatory when I was studying jazz guitar, a lot of amazing jazz and fusion players played like that with a closed fist, and they got tons of control and amazing articulation out of their playing compared to me back then. I was still picking very hard like that. And that obviously results in a lot of unwanted noise when you play like that. So once I started closing my fist, I got much, much better results. And this is something I can really recommend. You should really try that out to see if it works for you. So it doesn't look like that. There's absolutely no pressure. I'm just closing my fist and play like that nowadays. The next comment is from Noddy, and he says, your accent sounds very interesting. Where are you from, bro? Thanks a lot, Noddy, for asking that. I think I got it under control just a little bit more compared to my older videos.
It's always hard to get the same dynamic level for every note. That's the main goal here.
But I know that I still kind of sound like the Arnold Schwarzenegger of shred guitar playing. And just like him, I'm from Austria and I'm currently living in Vienna. Stargazing commented, I love how you included players from all levels and ages on your shred collab. Most other collabs are just very flashy. Damn, I'm 29 and I feel too old to learn guitar, but this video proves that I can still do it. First of all, thanks a lot for commenting that and for checking out the shred collab I attached to the video from last week. In my personal opinion and also in my experience as a teacher, you're never too young or too old to start playing guitar. All that really matters is that you really want to do this and that you're excited, and then you will see some great results if you keep practicing. So definitely don't think about it too much and just start. I'm sure you won't regret it. We definitely will do those community collaborations much more often next year. So if you would like to be in the next video on this channel, on the next collaboration video, make sure to check that out on patreon.com/Bernth and join us in the secret hidden Facebook group. Let's move to the next question from Dev Kemani. Don't those piercings come in the way while talking? Just curious. I actually have to say that I forget that I have them most of the time because I've had them for so long. I think for 10 or 15 years now. But of course, you can also put them together like that, and that makes talking very hard. That's why I don't do that. So Björn Schnabelteller is asking, have you ever thought about making an exercise book? So many great ideas. I would definitely buy it. Thanks a lot, Björn, for asking that. And that's actually another topic I'd like to have your opinion on, if possible. Do you still like to work with guitar books, so actual books or ebooks? Or is it all digital and online for you nowadays? I personally have great memories starting out with different books, learning my first scale shapes and all of that, so really thick actual books. But I honestly have no idea if this is still a popular thing that people do or if it's all online in the form of online courses and all of that stuff. I actually released something relatively close to an exercise book with my online courses 10 Steps to Modern Shredding and Sweep Picking Masterclass, in case you know about them. Both of these courses feature a PDF course workbook. I think the one for 10 Steps to Modern Shredding actually has 72 pages, so maybe that counts as a small guitar book already. As always, the links to those courses are in my description in case you're looking for something to work on over the holidays. Okay, the next one is from Ivan Negri, and he says, Bernd and Kiko Loureiro, two must-follow channels in YouTube for guitar players around the world. Cheers from Brazil. And this comment pretty much made my day because Kiko is one of my absolute favorite guitar players ever. I absolutely don't have to say this because you all know him, but if you're not subscribed to his channel, make sure to head over right now. He has some great content aside from being an amazing guitar player. And you should also check out his recent album Open Source if you want to hear some killer guitar playing. The next comment is from Steve, and he says, Bernd, I started playing guitar last summer, but seriously started daily practices around April. How long did it take you to get fast? A year? So first of all, thanks a lot for the great question, Steve, and congratulations on starting out with playing guitar and on taking it more seriously right now with daily practice sessions. Since I'm a pretty structured person, I remember this question very well. When I started out myself, I also always wanted to put tags on things like how long does it take to master sweep picking, to master alternate picking, how many hours, how many practice sessions, how many weeks, how long do I have to practice every day. But honestly, it's not that simple, and you can't assign an exact value to that kind of progress. Not only because we're all completely different as guitar players, also because of the definition of speed. And I'm not even talking about a BPM number right here, I'm talking about how clean can you actually play that stuff. Because there are a lot of players that play songs at 200 beats per minute, playing 16th notes, but they actually just go as fast as they possibly can, and they end up missing a lot of notes. So when you play a song like that, you can technically say, I can play at 200 beats per minute, but you don't really play a real note value and you just kind of play as fast as possible. So fast doesn't always mean good. To me, really clean and precise playing 16th notes at 150 or 160 beats per minute actually sound much faster than very sloppy playing at 200 beats per minute and above. In fact, I also made a video about it. Guess how fast this sequence is.
So let's see if you guessed it correctly. The tempo of this track is actually just 160 beats per minute, and I'm playing 16th notes in the guitar solo.
So as you can see on screen, this was actually pretty slow, but due to the clean execution, at least I tried my best to play that really, really clean, it sounded kind of fast and impressive. So especially if you're just starting out, my suggestion would be to aim for a precise and clean technique instead of just pushing for speed at the beginning. The next question is from Fabio Schenker, and he asks, do you speak German? Thanks for asking that, Fabio. Yes, I speak German. And in fact, I will post a shocking reveal of my German talking voice when we reach 300,000 subscribers. Just kidding, of course. Vielen Dank und liebe Grüße. The next question is from Mubashir Sheikh Mashu. I hope I said that correctly. I really gave it my best. Hi Bernd, your lessons have always helped me and a million others. Thanks a lot for sharing that. I have a question if you can help me with it. So since we practice alternate picking while sitting, whenever we play standing up, the whole technique gets a little challenging. Can you share tips for strap height and guitar angle? So if you have seen any of my live performances or any of my music videos or just videos of me playing that I'm posting on this channel, you will have seen that I don't really wear my guitars very low. In fact, I do the exact opposite. I wear them pretty high, so like that, because that gives me the best amount of support. It just feels very natural for me to play like that. And recently, a couple of months ago, I also started practicing like that. So when I play like that, both of my hands feel very similar than they do when I'm sitting down and practicing. In fact, I even get a bit more control out of the guitar, because if you just have it sitting on your lap, it's kind of moving around like that when you're playing. And right now, this is perfectly balanced. As you can see, when I'm not touching the instrument, it still remains in this position, so it's not moving like that, like some other guitar models. So when it comes to that, I always kind of just went with the most efficient solution that looks like that, instead of going for something that just looks really cool, like wearing your guitar down to your ankles or something like that. But I have to completely agree with you. I also always felt like I have to completely change my left and right hand technique when I was sitting down compared to when I was standing up and playing. So that's why I went for this approach. We have one more comment from Heavy Metal Hunk. Very helpful as always, Bernd. I was curious if there is anything for building confidence. I've been playing for 13 years, yet still feel like I'm not good enough. And listening to all the haters doesn't really help either. So thanks a lot for asking that. That's a really, really important topic, aside from all that talk about equipment, about technique, right-hand motion, left-hand motion, and all of that stuff. I'm still learning, improving, failing, and working on my skills all the time. And I think as hard as it is to accept that, that this is a never-ending journey and you never arrive at some point where you're completely happy and the perfect guitar player, this is kind of what it's all about for me and the reason why I decided to make this channel in the first place. And honestly, it would be kind of sad when you reach that point when you learned everything and you can play everything and you're just the perfect ultimate guitar player. I think that it's all about the journey when it comes to that, and I hope that you will keep going into this direction. Don't be intimidated by people that just want to hurt you online because it's fun for them. I honestly hope that you will keep working and practicing, and maybe some great things will happen that you don't even expect yet. And the last question is one that I got very frequently in the last couple of days. It's from Logan McGuffin, and he says, I have to admit, I didn't see this coming. How did you guys get the Hoff to do a metal song / video? In case you didn't see it yet, make sure to check out the metal song we made together with the one and only David Hasselhoff. I left the link in the description. Concerning how that all happened, it's actually a really, really long story that started around 2 years ago. We will eventually release some making of footage on the Q-Stack channel, so make sure to head over there and subscribe in case you want to see that. So thanks a lot for checking out the very first fireside Q&A session on this channel. Please let me know if you enjoyed this and if you should do that more often in the future next year. Thanks a lot for being part of my journey here on YouTube, and make sure to subscribe if you're not part of this guitar community yet. I will see you again next year. All the best and have a lot of fun practicing until then.